Okay, we're in the fifth series of questions. So in this case, we start with 2021, and our frequency is four periods, and we're doing quarters. So that should take us into 3, 6, 9, and 12. Those would be our quarters. And then our date range will be 1 through 5. The reason we go to 5 is it does not include the last number. And so the quarter then will set up as a series called quarterly, and we can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the next thing we want to do is set up 12 ranges, make them monthly, and we will re-index the quarterly to the monthly. And so let's take a look at the output. So you'll notice that for each quarter, I'm now getting the value of 1. So we'll re-index to the monthly, and we have now, here is each month, 1, 2, 3, first quarter hits, 4, 5, 6, second quarter hits, 7, 8, 9, third quarter hits, 10, 11, 12, and then fourth quarter. Okay, in this example, we have two dates. We have a date range, 1-1 through 12-29-2016, and we are going to run it in a monthly series. So we'll just create our data, which will equal the values 1 and 2, and index will be the monthly dates, and we'll print out monthly. So you can see that we have 1, 2, 1, and 2. So that's our two dates, 131 and 229. They wanted to find the last day of the month. Okay, so the next thing we'll do is we'll go to the weekly, so we can calculate out which end of week, starting month, starting day, and we'll re-index weekly dates, and then we'll backfill those weekly dates with values. So backfill is looking at the current, the previous one, and they're backfilling in. So 11/31 would be the top, so we'll backfill to 24/17/10/3 for that month. Okay, this example we have tuples. Each one of the tuples, a list of tuples. Each one of the tuple has country, a date, and a value. And so we'll just create a data frame from those tuples. And we want to convert, set the date time for date, set the index to country and date, and then print it out. So here's our our hierarchical index. And we can see country and date and then value. So now if we look at what the minimum date is, we'll go to the second, we'll go to the second level layer, which is the date, and we'll look then for the minimum date. So we'll start our start ranges, and then we'll end, our frequency will be 7 day, and then we'll print out the weeks. So this example shows how we can re-index using the multi-index and the from product. So the from product will be country and then weekly dates. So here's the results. We have our country and then our cross product with the weekly dates. Okay, in this example, there was just a little bit of information, but we wanted to look at using a plot, so I'm going to show you the end results. So it was kind of trying to figure out where people were spending their time. So you have breakfast, dinner, grooming, leaving, lunch, shower, sleeping, snack, spare time and TV, and toileting. And if you look at the largest amount of time we spend in our leisure time, sleeping occupied quite a bit, but look at the amount of time that was spent on TV. You know, they don't have exercising in the list, but they were spending a lot of time on media. I found that kind of interesting, that trend is, you know, gaming and so forth. So just took in the data points, looked at the activity, group it by the day of the year and the duration in minutes, and found the averages. Then this function here, two flat index, was used to grade the index, because I can then iterate through the index, and I can get the activities and the month, and then the values, and then I can plot those out where I have activities, values, and the month, and I'll put it in a log scale. Okay, let's look at this section here. So this one I'm running through, and we do a group by activity, and we're looking at activity, day of the year, duration. We'll set the filter by activity. We'll get the durations, the date, and the summary. We'll get the minute, the mean minutes, the max date, and then we will set the loc. We'll update using the length of the summary, and then we'll set it equal to the activity, day of the year, duration, and date. What this does is it has this effect of creating an append. That's equivalent to an append. And then we can now reset the index to date, get the minimum date, the maximum date. Daily will be a range. We'll start with the min date to the max date. Frequency will be date. And we'll look at activities, breakfast and sleeping. We'll filter on breakfast, and then we will set breakfast, reindexing that with backfill. We'll repeat that process for sleep, spare time, and then we'll plot it out. So now you can kind of see the pattern here. The first one is for, let's see, which one is it? Sleeping. So it should put up other PLT title sleeping. And let's see, what is this one? This one's our spare time. And then we saw that pattern above, and this is just kind of highlighting that the pattern above. Now if we run that, it's going to take a little while because it's going to have to chunk through the data. We can get kind of a trend, so we can see our trend. Whereas our sleeping patterns out here, notice there's kind of a spike. This is probably bad data here, but you can see the general trend over time. Sleeping, there's some looks like maybe we could put this into maybe a seasonal decomposition and see if we can find a particular trend. But you'll notice that the sleeping patterns are fairly consistent. Looks like at this point it's kind of dropping off. Kind of wonder what might be happening here. Maybe something that is affecting it with longer days or less light or more light, and they're getting up earlier, so they're sleeping less or playing less. This is actually. Let's see, what was that? That this is the sleeping pattern, and then here is the spare time, and it kind of moves in a cycle also. Okay, I think I'll stop there. Happy Python coding.